Hey everybody, Dr. O. This is the review of metabolism and energy production. So it's going to be kind of short because the first point here, over the years, I've created this metabolism fact sheet to truly be what I want you to know. So I'm not just going to read it to you here, which is basically what I would do. So between your metabolism videos and the metabolism fact sheet, you should have a lot of this down. So I'm really kind of working on the fringes here, working on the edges. So I'll read the point. The metabolism fact sheet that you were given is a critical thing to study. Understand what goes into every step, what comes out, and how much energy is produced along the way. So most of what you have to know is going to be in that 2.5-page document. So just flat out bullet points. Here's what goes in. Here's what comes out. Here's how much energy is produced, etc. So make sure you know that. That's a really, really important compliment. This is really a compliment to that. All right. Define metabolism, anabolism, and catabolism. So metabolism is the sum of all the chemical and physical processes occurring in your body. But another way, let's look at the other two terms, and I'll come back to that. Anabolism is anything that builds something and requires energy. So it leads to growth and requires energy. Catabolism is the breakdown of something that releases energy. So the reason I put these three terms together is how I like to define metabolism is anabolism plus catabolism. So the sum of all the things that are happening that require energy to build stuff in your body and all the things that are happening that break down things to release energy in your body and all the building blocks too. So metabolism is anabolism plus catabolism. Okay, which organelle is responsible for 95% of ATP production? That is your mitochondria. The rest occurs during glycolysis, and glycolysis is the anaerobic process that occurs in the cytoplasm of your cell. So it's not exactly 95.9, or 95.5, the average cell in our body can turn a molecule of glucose into 36 ATP. Two ATP are produced as a net gain during glycolysis out in the cell, cytosol. The rest is happening in the mitochondria. All right, what is the general equation for cellular respiration? So that would be glucose or whatever fuel source we're looking at plus oxygen leads to ATP plus carbon dioxide plus water. That is the equation for our metabolism. The fuel substrate will determine how much ATP and everything else, but that's the basics. Define gluconeogenesis. So I'll go work backwards. Genesis means creation. Neo means new. Gluco means glucose, so the creation of new glucose. So the textbook definition is the creation of carbohydrates out of non-carbohydrate sources. So usually this means proteins. They're the glycerol backbone from fat can be turned into glucose, but 95% of give or take is going to come from protein sources, amino acids. So if we need glucose and we can't get it from somewhere, we can make it. That's gluconeogenesis. Which of the three macronutrients, carbs, lipids, or proteins, are broken down by beta oxidation? That is fat. So we have these, let's say we're dealing with a fat with 16 carbon long, a triglyceride, so a glycerol backbone with three tails. Each of those tails has 16 carbons, let's say. Well, beta oxidation is chopping off those carbons two at a time and then turning them into acetyl-CoA. And then acetyl-CoA is going to run through your metabolism just like the acetyl-CoA that comes from breaking down glucose. So fat is beta oxidized. You get a lot of energy from fat. It's just that's a slow process. That's why we say fat's your primary fuel source when you're resting. Glucose is when you need quick energy. All right, what are the two electron carriers used in cellular respiration? How many ATPs are each worth? That'll be NADH and FADH2. NADH is a byproduct of niacin, the B vitamin. FADH2 is a byproduct of riboflavin, a different B vitamin. So NADH is going to be, each NADH is going to be worth 3 ATP. Each FADH2 is going to be worth 2, so give or take. So those are the two electron carriers, NADH, FADH2, and they're worth 3 ATPs and 2 ATPs apiece, respectively. What is the net gain of ATP during glycolysis? That is 2. So the reason we say that specifically, net gain, is because there's an energy investment phase where you actually spend 2 ATP during glycolysis, and there's an energy payoff phase where you make 4. So you spend 2 ATP to make 4. That's why we say there's a net gain of 2 ATP. And lastly, in the absence of oxygen, what does pyruvate become? It becomes lactic acid or lactic acid. So if there's enough oxygen, when glucose splits into pyruvate, it will become acetyl-CoA and run through the Krebs cycle electron transport chain. In the absence of oxygen, pyruvate becomes lactic acid. So, which we can actually convert and we can use as a fuel source and do other things with it. But it's usually seen as kind of a waste product. I think that's a simple way to look at it, but for now, that'll be fine. Okay, so like I said, this is super short because this is, I mean, I could just sit here and read this 2.5-page document to you. This is what I want you to know besides what's on your metabolism fact sheet, okay? It's all right. I wish you the best of luck with this content. I know metabolism and cellular respiration is not easy. So let me know how I can help. Be blessed.